It's ESPR, the jeans low head high arms cross kid with the black tee.
Welcome back to my channel, you guys. It's been like a hot ass minute since I've posted anything up on my channel. Says it's been like 3 weeks. I just want to come on here and update you guys on what's been going on and this whole coronavirus shit. So I guess for starters, the biggest thing aside from the coronavirus that's been happening in my life is that my dog Mickey, that you guys have seen up on my channel before, he died on the 15th of February. Since I've posted videos with Mickey up on my channel and I've told you guys about him before, I feel like I had to give you guys this update and just let you guys know about what happened. In my day in my life video, I told you guys that we've had Mickey. It was gonna be 11 years in April. We got him April 27th of 2009. We got him from the Adams County Animal Shelter. From when we got him, he was actually 2 years old. So it was gonna be 11 years in April since we got him. But a really fucked up thing happened. You know, like I told you guys, Mickey used to love to be running outside. As soon as the door was open, he'd dip. And my biggest concern, like I told you guys in my day in my life video, was him getting hit by a car. Like I told you guys, just the thought of Mickey not being around one day was really heartbreaking. So now actually living in that reality really fucking sucks. On the weekends, my dad doesn't work. My dad wakes up super, super early every single weekend. So Mickey would wake up early too with my dad, and my dad would let him run around. And I would always tell my dad not to do that because I didn't want him getting hit by a car. But since my dad does wake up super early around that time frame, no cars pass by for shit. Literally the only person that's on our street during that time is my dad. It was kind of like a thing that Mickey knew that on the weekends my dad would let him run around. It was Saturday. My dad let him run out, you know, and Mickey would just go. And, you know, he was like a really friendly dog. A lot of the people in the neighborhood knew that he was our dog. My dad let him run out. And I guess a little while later, our next door neighbor came to the house and let my dad know that there had been an incident at his house with his dogs and Mickey. My dad goes over, sees the situation, then he comes to wake me up. And it was super early in the morning. My dad came and told me that something had happened to Mickey at the next door neighbor's house, that he had gotten like in a fight with one of the neighbor's dogs and that he got injured. So I was thinking, you know, like, oh my God, like they probably like broke his leg or something that we could just take him to the vet and he could get fixed. Then I went over to a neighbor's house and there was Mickey laying in their front yard, just laying there. And then when I got up closer to him, I seen that he had a lot of blood all over him. He was wearing his little red sweater. You know, at first I thought it was just his sweater. And then when I got up closer, I seen that he was covered in blood. So I obviously started losing my shit. I guess what had happened was our next door neighbors have 3 Labrador dogs, and one of them that we've known since she was a fucking baby, for whatever reason, she decided to attack Mickey. Her name is Molly. She got Mickey right in his like jugular vein. So she basically ripped open his whole like this side of his throat and like neck. The neighbors, they felt really bad about what happened. So they volunteered to take me to the vet and, to pay for the bills. It was like a whole mission. We had to go to 3 different vets. By the 3rd one that we got, they do like urgent care. The other 2 that we went to, the first one only did shots. The second vet that we went to, they said that he needed like urgent care, and that's not like they didn't have all this stuff that they were gonna need there. The 3rd place that we went to, I went in there and I was fucking like crying and shit, and it was like so icy out, and I fucking like fell with Mickey in my arms. Luckily I didn't drop him, but like I fell in the fucking ice, busted my shit. Then we went inside and they took a look at him. They like took him back right away and they like looked at him. They said that they could do surgery. It was gonna be a $600 deposit, and then we were gonna be looking at a few thousand after that. So I let my dad know. He transferred me the $600, and you know, when I'm filling out all the paperwork and stuff, the vet called me to the back. And I've been through this before, not with a pet obviously, but I've been through this before with my little brother. It was like, it reminded me a lot of that situation. So when she called me to the back, I knew it wasn't gonna be good. The moment that I seen him outside in my neighbor's yard, I knew that it wasn't gonna be good. But I was just trying to stay calm, you know, like for Mickey, and I was telling him everything was gonna be okay. And I was just like rubbing him, like his little feet. And she called me to the back and, you know, she sat me down and she told me, you know, the reality of the situation, which I knew wasn't good. The vet, she came out and told me, she was like, look, we can do surgery on him, but because of his age and because of how severe the injuries are, he's gonna die either way. You know, you're just basically gonna prolong the situation. Or, you know, she said the most humane thing to do would be to put him down. You know, I was by myself when all of this happened. My dad was at home with the babies, and I was there at the vet. My neighbor was there, but he wasn't in the back with me when it was all happening. But, like, I told him, like, well, yeah, put him down. Like, I'm not gonna... You know, he's already gone through, like, he's been in a really fucked up situation. He hasn't had any medical assistance from here. It, like, took, like, a whole hour by the time that the attack happened to the time that we went through all those vets and everything. When we were at that last spot, it had been, like, a whole hour. You know, I'm like, he's already suffered a shit ton. He wasn't making any noises. He wasn't really doing anything. He would twitch every now and then, but he wasn't really doing anything. I don't know if the dog got, like, his vocal cords or what. I don't know. Because Mickey, he was, like, really, like, vocal. He was a very vocal dog. But he wasn't doing anything. And just like I made the decision to take my little brother off of life support, I was going to do the same thing for my dog. Like, he's part of my family, you know. And I would never prolong someone's inevitable situation just for my own, you know, just like for my own self, if that makes any sense. It just didn't make any sense on why to, like, prolong his situation or just keep him like that, you know, Mickey. For what? You know, and I mean, I knew I was gonna lose him either way, and I didn't want him to suffer. He was, like, a really good dog. I didn't want him to suffer, so I signed all the paperwork. And the doctor came in and she did what she had to do. And I gave Mickey a kiss on his little head. And I was telling him about how he was such a good dog. And yeah, and I told him that, you know, that everything was going to be okay. And that it was okay for him to go. And that I told him, like, Lewis is waiting for you. So, you know, like, it's okay that you, like, you could go. And yeah, and I just told him that he was a good dog. And that's the last thing that he heard. His heart stopped immediately. I had signed the paperwork for him to be cremated. I kept his sweater. This is a sweater that he was wearing. I did wash it because there was a little bit of blood on it. And I kept his collar. I had to wash that too because it had blood on it. I kept some of his stuff. I actually have some of his stuff. This little stuff right here, that's his collar. He's in there. We had him cremated and they gave us, like, this super pretty little urn thing. Had his leash that I would take him out with. His little toys that he got for Christmas, which are those two. Those are the ones he got for Christmas. His favorite little squeaky toy, it was this one and this one. And he liked that. We bought it for Panchito, but Mickey liked it better. And this little toy here too. We actually got his little paw print. They did that for him after he had died. Got this little note from the vet, and then I have two pictures up of us. So that's why I've been in a, like, really weird funk. I was devastated as fuck for days, and then just like I always do when one of my family members passes away, I went into shock. And I've been in shock ever since. So, you know, I know it's not the best coping mechanism, but it's been really hard, you guys. It's been hard on all of us. My dad, he felt so guilty about it. My kids, oh my God. Addie, she's still too little to understand. But my son, they went to go pick me up at the vet's office. And when they went, my son was asking, he said, "Where's Mickey?" Grandpa said that him and the neighbor's dog got in a fight. And I just told him, well, like, Mickey's with your Uncle Lewis now, and he understood what that meant. My son, he's so sweet. He loves the Odd Ones Out. The Odd Ones Out, he had one of his dogs pass away, and he, in his video, he said, "They're not in our lives forever." And that's what Janny told me. He's like, "It's okay, Mom." He's like, "Just remember, like, the Odd Ones Out said, they're not in our lives forever." But then, like, by, like, the second or third day, my son started crying a lot because he loved Mickey. He would wake up early in the mornings with him, and he would, like, hang out with him, and he was always, like, posting videos of him, taking pictures with him, and he's an animal lover. He's taking it really hard. So I got this stuffed animal dog, and we put the little sweater on him, and I got Janny the same kind of dog with another sweater of Mickey just to, like, help him So whenever he gets really sad, he'll like go and hug him. And I sleep with this dog every night, and Danny sleeps with his every night. But it's been hard. Panchito's been struggling a lot with it too, which is crazy because Panchito, he was like that annoying little brother to Mickey. He's been having like a hard time too. He hasn't really been eating that well. He's been kind of like sad, just hanging out, not really doing anything. I have no idea right now if I even want to get another dog. I know my kids, they do, but me, I'm really not sure. Mickey, he was like the sweetest little thing. So the whole situation really fucked me up mentally. Like, I had a mental breakdown in the vet's office. Like I said, it was just a lot too similar to what's happened with my little brother. I mean, the whole thing was just really bad. You know, and I looked down, like, my hands were covered in Mickey's blood. My hoodie was covered in Mickey's blood. So it was just a lot. Mickey was a really sweet dog, and if you guys have been watching my channel for a while, you guys know that Mickey got his teeth extracted, and the majority of them too. It was really fucked up because even if he wanted to defend himself against the neighbor's dog, it's not like he even had teeth to do it. It was just a really fucked up way for him to die. I know that he was getting a lot older, and I know we never get to choose how our loved ones pass, but Mickey didn't deserve what happened to him. So, you know, it's been a lot. There's been a lot of death in my life in the last 6 years. As you guys know, I lost both of my brothers and now my poor Mickey in the last 6 years. And I loved Mickey a lot. Obviously, I don't see my pets as like animals. I see them like part of my family. They're my family members, and I'm related to a shit ton of people. But my family is this. My family is what I have at home, you know, like my parents and, you know, my fur babies. So it was really, really, really hard losing my Mickey. Even though he was a lot older, he didn't act like he was older. He seriously, the whole entire time that we had him, he seriously acted like a little 3-year-old kid. Me, the way that I deal with stuff is I don't deal with stuff. I kind of just bury it deep inside. I guess from doing that, I don't know, it affects me physically. And then my face started breaking out like crazy again. And I was like, fuck. From one day to the next, I was like, I couldn't stop crying. And then the next day, I was just like in shock. And then my face started going crazy. My eating patterns are affected a lot by the way that I feel. As you guys know, I've been diagnosed with severe depression, severe anxiety, and PTSD. Sometimes I'll feel too anxious where I can't eat. Sometimes I'm so depressed where I won't feel hungry at all that whole entire day. And other days, I feel so depressed that I can't stop eating. So this has been like a mixture of both. I miss my baby a lot. I've tried not to think about it, you know, and try to comfort myself thinking that he is with Lewis. When we got Mickey, my older brother Junior had already gone off to the army and everything, so he didn't really know Mickey that well. Mickey knew Lewis. I try to comfort myself thinking that they're together, but it's just hard because, like I said, both of my brothers and my dog all died in a really fucked up way, in a way that they didn't deserve. So, you know, it takes its toll. I was planning to take therapy. I did get in contact with a therapist that I've had over the years, and he was helping me get set up with a new therapist. But now with this whole coronavirus thing, bitch, I'm not trying to leave my house. So I didn't even set up the appointments. Hopefully this whole thing passes and everything's good so I can go to therapy, because like this whole thing is taking its toll on me. And I was just in a really weird headspace. So that's the update with that. I lost my family member. So all right, now with this whole coronavirus shit, you guys, I'm fucking scared. You guys seem like it's getting really crazy. I live here in Colorado. As of yesterday, I think that they have closed. They said that they were going to close all the businesses, all the bars, restaurants. They said there was going to be only a handful of things open, which is like the grocery stores, the banks. I know that they've closed all of the schools. I wasn't really worried about that because, like you guys know, I homeschool my kid. I seen how fast stuff started getting really crazy. I personally don't really go out. I mean, I go out. I de vez en cuando. I was actually going to go out on Saturday to a rave with one of my friends. And they canceled it the day before, which I wasn't really like upset about because I was kind of nervous because I'm like, you guys, as you guys know, I have my little EDC backpack when I go to raves. So when I went to Walmart and I was looking like for the hand wipes and the soap and stuff, there was none. And I started panicking because I'm like, I need I need to wash my hands. I need no germs. So I started freaking out. So when they canceled the rave, I was a little bit relieved. So I was like, shit, you know, I didn't have any of my stuff. I was not going to be prepared. And the last thing I want to do is bring the germs home to my kids. We are all getting a refund for our tickets. I think we did go out on Sunday. Not go out, but we had to go to the store to try to, like, sell some stuff at GameStop. And they've been talking about, like, social distancing. Everybody needs to be staying home. And I live close to a park. And when we were driving by, that park was full of people. Everybody was just chilling, hanging out, partying and shit. And I'm like,
bruh.
Also, they've closed some clubs here in downtown Denver. But I know that the ones that they were open, I seen some people, like, on Facebook and Instagram, just out and about having a good time, and each their own. I just think that, correct me if I'm wrong, but I personally feel like that if we just stay home for the next, like, 2-3 weeks, this whole thing might blow over a lot sooner. So then we can go out and celebrate and have a good ass time and shit. Also, the grocery store. Oh my god, you guys. I was really freaked out because, you know, for the most part, there was a lot of groceries left. I go grocery shopping every single week because we only buy enough groceries for the week. We eat a lot, you guys. When I'm like, okay, everything seems pretty chill. And then when I got to the cleaning supplies, the shelves were completely empty, you guys. I was like, no. Because coronavirus or not, I'm a germaphobe. You guys know that. If you guys watch my videos, you guys know that. Whenever I feel, like, dirty, or if my hands are dirty, I will start losing my shit. Bitch, I'm losing my shit just talking about this right now. If I feel dirty, my anxiety goes through the fucking roof. And I'm a hot-ass mess. I started panicking when I was like, God, there is no cleaning supplies. How am I gonna disinfect my phone? How am I gonna disinfect my steering wheel? How am I gonna clean this? How am I gonna clean that? So I started freaking out. And I was like, it's okay. Let me just go get my hand soap, because I am addicted to washing my hands. I went and the soap completely gone. I was like, bitch, I was just here last week. There was a shitload of soap. And I had been seeing stuff, like, on Twitter. Because, like, a few, like, 2 or 3 weeks ago, I started seeing, like, the coronavirus hysteria where everybody was, like, freaking out. And they're like, you guys stock up on supplies and this and that. So I seen that before it started getting all crazy on Facebook. But I was like, well, no, you know, like, I think we'll be okay. So luckily, I did go to the dollar store, and the dollar store had hand soap. So I was like, all right, you know, just grab what I needed. I said, everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be okay. And then a lot of the shit's gone now, too. I went to the dollar store yesterday because I'm almost out of hand soap. And the hand soap was completely gone. I was like, you guys. Why do you guys keep doing this? I did get lucky, though, because when I went to Walmart, I walked to just see if they had any of the disinfecting wipes, and they didn't. And I said out loud, I was like, oh, man. And this lady was passing by me at the same time that I said that, and she asked me, she was like, were you looking for, like, the Clorox wipes? And I said, yeah. And she was like, oh, she had, like, a 3-pack of the disinfecting ones, like the knockoff version of the Clorox. And she's like, here, you can have these. She's like, my mom just said that she grabbed some, so she said to put these back in case anybody needed them, so you can have. I said, oh my god, like, lady, if this virus was not going around, sis, I might give you a hug, maybe, because I don't really like to be touched, but maybe, because I was so relieved. So me and my kids posted, like, a funny ass TikTok about that shit, because, bitch, I was happy. I have a thing with germs.
It's corona time. Hey, it's corona time right now. It's corona time. It's corona time.
I'm really scared just because I'm scared of it. First of all, we did have the flu in, like, February, like, early February. And I'm like, this is what I get for fucking bragging, because I was, like, bragging my day in my live video about how he haven't gotten sick because Jenny's been out of school, and we actually got the flu in a really stupid way.
Ow, so stupid!
I tell everybody in my house, do not be sharing drinks with people, do not be sharing blunts with people, don't share this with people, don't share that with people. If you touch a fucking gas pump, disinfect your hands. If you touch a shopping cart, disinfect your hands, make sure you wash your hands. I just have a lot of crazy rules in place for a good ass reason. Someone, I'm not gonna say who, someone didn't listen and decided to share something with someone. And then they came home, and within 2 days, everyone in the house was sick as fuck, you guys. Me, I was like sick as fuck for like one whole day, and then I was good. But everybody in my house was like in bed. It got really like bad. Benny, he has asthma. We had to take him to the hospital. They had to put him on some oxygen. They had to give him some steroids. It was a big thing. And then the baby, she got really sick. She not only had the flu, she also had croup. She went through a lot of fucked up tests. It was a lot. If you know, they're saying that the coronavirus is worse than the flu, I don't even want to fucking think about it. For the most part, everybody in my house is pretty healthy, except for my dad and Danny. My dad, he does have high blood pressure. So, and then with Danny, he has asthma. I'm really afraid of what this could do to him. My mom lives in Texas, so she doesn't live here, but she is feeling sick, so I'm hoping that it's just like a cold or it's something else. He does have pre-diabetes, so I'm really afraid. So hopefully, you know, like my mom and my dad and Danny don't get it at all. I hope nobody here in my house gets it at all. I know that they're recommending social distancing. Like I said, we don't really go out. I go out to like a club or like a rave or something like once or twice every few months, if that. I don't really have any friends. But I really love to go to the movies, and that's something that we do every weekend. But they did close all the movie theaters. So the only thing I really like to do is I like to go eat fast food. I love fast food. I love Chipotle. I love the tortas from Tortugas, so fucking bomb. But right now with this whole situation, you know, I'm afraid to even like eat out because, bitch, what if somebody gets sick and then they touch my food and then, I don't know, I'm scared. You guys, so I just wanted to give you guys some tips on what I'm doing for, you know, just about what I regularly do anyways. If you guys can find any of these wet ones, that would be good. I actually carry one of these in my bag. Whenever I've been going grocery shopping now, I wear disposable gloves to touch the shopping cart. Whenever I buy any liquids or anything that can be held, I wipe it down with a Clorox wipe as soon as I get home. Constantly disinfect my whole entire car with Clorox wipes, the steering wheel, the music buttons, the door handles, the window buttons, the shifter, anything that's touched, I disinfect it like crazy. I've been disinfecting my purse, my phone. I constantly disinfect my phone. We have like this Lysol spray. I've been going disinfecting the all of the doorknobs, the light switches and everything, and then spraying it down with the Lysol too. Make sure you guys are washing your hands. I constantly wash my hands. My hands get so dry because I have a thing with washing the shit out of my hands. You know, shit, it's paying off to be a germaphobe right now. So they've been recommending social distancing. And that was actually something I wanted to ask you guys. Comment down below. Are you guys doing the social distancing? Yes or no? Why or why not? I know I've seen some people on Facebook saying that it's a big deal. The government's just trying to control everybody. And other people that are like, you guys, we can't be selfish. You know, a lot of us have like older people. I have my grandmas. My grandmas are both alive, and I have one grandpa. So I do have older people that I'm worried about. I personally am social distancing because, for one, I'm not a people person. Two, because like I said, I don't want to bring this home. The flu really knocked everybody down in my house. So I can't imagine what the coronavirus would do. Comment down below. I'm interested in what you guys are doing, or like what you guys are not doing. Are you guys listening to what they're saying? Are you guys not listening? Also comment down below, what tips do you guys have on how to stay clear of this coronavirus? I need to go buy groceries either today or tomorrow, so I'm scared to see what the grocery store looks like right now. Also, we don't bulk buy. So comment down below, did you guys bulk buy, yes or no? Why or why not? I'm interested to know, like, what are you guys doing about it? But we don't bulk buy. We buy for every week. Yes, okay, we spend a lot just buying every week because, like I said, we eat a lot. Like, do you guys work? What is your job doing about it right now? I'm a stay-at-home mom, so I don't have a job. I am planning to have some new content out here for you guys. I just wanted to give you guys a little update on my life for right now. But follow me on my Instagram, follow me on my Twitter, also follow me on TikTok. I'm planning to post more videos on there. Please stay safe. Don't forget to wash your hands. Try to be as clean as fuck. Ojalá todo esto pase. Hopefully life goes back to normal pretty soon.